Okay, we are about to go green flag racing as Pittman and Taylor will lead this field up to speed as they roll through turns 3 and 4. Pittman on the gas, and he's going to gain the advantage. Taylor's going to tuck right under the rear. Oh, trouble as Paul Smith gets crossed up. The 53 of John Baker also involved, many cars avoiding the collision as they roll into turns 3 and 4. The field will tighten up. Keep an eye on the pole sitter, Phil Pittman. This time, not much different than last time. Pittman will lead the field down into turn 1. Oh, Justin Sapp's gonna wheel hop, he loses a tire. And Justin Sapp is gonna end up on his lid, but don't panic. Listen, guys, don't panic. Whitney and the rest of the family, that was a very slow, gentle rollover as Justin Sapp loses the right rear tire and the car wheel hopped, got up in the air, and race fans, give him a big hand. We're being told that the driver, Justin Sapp, is okay. He's gonna celebrate his birthday tomorrow. This time, not much different than last time. Pittman will lead the field down into turn 1. Oh, Justin Sapp's gonna wheel hop, he loses a tire. And Justin Sapp is gonna end up on his lid, but don't panic. Listen, guys, don't panic. Whitney and the rest of the family. Speed. And Josh Taylor all over the bumper of the 3 car. It'll be Pittman, Taylor, and McDaniel Jr. A little further back, Morgan Sheffield rides in 4th, then Paul Smith in 5th, and the 14 of Josh Taylor really putting the pressure. But Phil Pittman, the veteran driver, he is handling it well. And once again, Taylor really pushing hard. Pittman, Taylor, and McDaniel. Then a little ways back as Cameron Hall will slip to the low side of Paul Smith. Caution, we've got a car in turn 2 that's lost the handle. And from here, I believe that is going to be the 16 of Morgan Sheffield. Kind of hard to see, but I believe that's the 16 of Sheffield, and it's moving. And Phil Pittman patiently waiting. He will pull the trigger, and now Taylor's going to look to the outside. And once again, that right rear barely hanging on. Lots of hard racing. Corey Dunn looks to the inside of Craig Usry. Cameron Hall now is going to get crossed up. Hall able to hang on, a great save by the 17. And that really shuffles the lineup. It'll be Phil Pittman, Josh Taylor, Wiley McDaniel Jr., and Paul Smith. Now Josh Taylor will fake to the outside. He'll go back to the inside, and Pittman will turn him back as everybody goes right down to the apron of the track. Taylor to the outside once again. Pittman unable to hold him off, and Josh Taylor makes the pass. On the outside, Josh Taylor with a gutsy move. He tested that outside line several laps, finally able to make it stick, and the 14 gets by and he's driving away. Racing from front to back. These guys really mixing it up all the way throughout this field. It's going to be Josh Taylor, your leader. Phil Pittman second. Wiley McDaniel Jr. third. Paul Smith fourth. And Craig Usry now being shown in the fifth spot. Up on the tail end of the field, Josh Taylor. Oh, and the 49 of Wesley Robertson goes over the hill on the backstretch. Not exactly sure what happened there. So far, no caution as Robertson has kind of disappeared behind that bank over there. And now the caution will wave. I see the orange, and the caution comes out. Josh Taylor made a great pass on the outside of William Fisher, eighth. Then comes Bucci Floyd, John Baker, and then further back, the three of Collins and Wesley Robertson, and away we go. Fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh spot, man. They are really mixing it up down there. Caution on the speedway. The three car of Bruce Collins Jr. gets crossed up, and he's sitting in the groove, so a caution will come out. I don't think that Collins hit anything. And Taylor will pull away. Man, what a great start by Taylor. I mean, he just walked away from the field. Jr. loses the handle, and what a great piece of driving by Cameron Hall and several cars behind. And Cameron Hall rounds out the top five. And once again, look at the power in the 14 car on these restarts. Just about loses the handle, and once again everybody has to react quickly behind him. Another great job of driving. Josh Taylor absolutely putting on a dominating performance as Paul Smith just about loses that car on the backstretch. He's going to give up the third spot. Greg Usry gets by. And quite honestly, Paul Smith fortunate that he didn't lose more. A great, great save. Oh, trouble in turns one and two. William Fisher, Wiley McDaniel Jr., and I believe that is going to be Bruce Collins Jr. all involved. Set to go back green flag racing, and Josh Taylor has been absolutely dominating on these restarts. And once again, he really launches that car. Hard racing further back in the field. That's going to be for about the fifth and sixth spot. And Paul Smith, Corey Dunn, Cameron Hall, all a part of that mix. Now Corey Dunn will dip to the inside of Paul Smith. He's going to grab fourth. Craig Usry next in line. And Craig Usry having a great run, man. Right now being shown in third, Corey Dunn. And once again, the battle a little further back. And Paul Smith has absolutely lost the handle on the 23. He's just hanging on at this point. That's a shame, man. Paul was as high as third or fourth at one point. The handle has gone away. And Corey Dunn, the young man in the 21 car, he has marched all the way to the third spot, having a great run. And Paul Smith is going to go ahead and bring it to the pits. And Smith, a former champion here at Cochran, knows how to get it done, but he also knows when it's not your night. Oh, Craig Usry spins. Baker is going to clip the front end of the car, and it'll spin Craig Usry around like a top. Corey Dunn third in the 21. Cameron Hall having a good run. He's climbed to fourth in the 17. And now John Baker will be shown in fifth in car 53. Corey Dunn keeping the pressure on Pittman, but the veteran in the three car, he knows how to get it done. Getting the most out of that car as Josh Taylor continues his dominance with just two green flag laps in the books. Josh Taylor has opened up almost a straightaway on the field. It'll be two laps to go this time by. Trigger. Phil Pittman second. Now Corey Dunn in third. Baker will get his spot back. He'll restart fourth. And how about Wesley Robertson staying in the game and right now being shown in fifth as Corey Dunn goes to the outside to try to clear the three of Pittman. Pittman going to race him hard as we are running out of time as they come off of turn four. Oh, more trouble. Cameron Hall gets crossed up. Another caution comes out. And once again, unable to put this one away, as I believe this is the third time that we've had problems, and Taylor immediately takes off in turn three as Pittman goes up to block the high side. Corey Dunn will now race him into turn one. And Corey Dunn will muscle his way into second. White flag in the air. Josh Taylor hoping that everybody stays clean behind him. One lap remaining. As Josh Taylor once again goes down the back straightaway for the final time. And the 14 car is going to put it away. Josh Taylor will be your winner in the Baldwin Builders Supply Sportsman portion Folks, give it up for Josh Taylor, your winner in the Baldwin Builder Supply Sportsman Feature. Josh, first off, man, congratulations on a great run. And you absolutely showed us tonight that you can get it done on the top side. Tell us about that pass, man.
He kept trying to block me down on the bottom, and I kept putting my nose in there, and I knew he was just leaving the top open, so I sailed it off in there.
Absolutely, man. A great, great run there. Josh, you have done really, really well in the Sportsman Division. This is by no means your first win here. But, Guy, I want to ask you, whether you're in your late model or your Sportsman car, man, you are very, very strong in qualifying. It don't matter which car you show up with, you're always going to be a threat for the pole. What is it about the qualifying that fits your style so much?
Well, it's a team effort. It all starts at the shop. And without the guys to help me, we wouldn't even be able to be here every weekend. So I got to thank every one of them. So, and that's pretty much, you know.
Man, I tell you, we congratulate you. You were up there on the front row, and tonight you really had to work for it. Josh, we congratulate you, buddy. Give it up one more time. Your winner in the Baldwin Builder Supply Sportsman Feature, Mr. Josh Taylor. Right now, I'm going to turn it back over to the voice of the Southern All-Star Super Late Models, my good buddy, Mr. Dwayne.